Okay, our subject for today is vertical motion. These topics will be taken up will be falling bodies. Now we are going to study the motion of a falling bodies. Downward and upward motion. For example, this is a cliff and you are going to drop an object downward, and another one is at the bottom of a cliff, you're going to throw also an object upward. Therefore, we are going to study two motion of an object. One is going down and another one is going up. Okay, the formula to be taken up from falling bodies is the formula BF is equal to BI plus GP, where BF is the final velocity, while the VI is the initial velocity, meaning final, that will be the velocity of the object when at the bottom already, while the initial is the initial velocity of the object upon throwing downward. Initial meaning that is the start of the velocity, and the final meaning the final or the end velocity of the object. And we can see by and by from the two motion, downward and upward, which is going faster or going slower. Okay. G is the gravity. Gravity. The fall of gravity. This is the gravity. This is the vertical pull of the earth to any object suspended at the air, which is equivalent to 9.8 meter per second square. The final velocity has a unit also of meter per second. Initial velocity equal, just the same, meter per second. And T here, T from the formula is equal to time, the given time or duration that the object will last from the initial going to the final velocity, which is, ang unit ng T is second. Okay, now we are going to solve an example of these two falling bodies going down and going upward. Number one example. For example, the example one is find the initial velocity of an object after 10 seconds. Find the initial velocity of the object after 10 seconds. Ibig sabihin, pagkatapos ng 10 segundo, ano ang initial velocity ng object na ibinato papaba, kung ang kanya, if its final velocity is 100 meter per second. Okay. What is being asked is the initial velocity, meaning the velocity at the start that the object will be falling down. Okay, the formula, we are going to use this formula. This is the general formula, but we are going to find the initial velocity. In solving for initial velocity, the formula will be this one. Vi is equal to Pf minus. Okay. Negative Vi in transforming this general formula. Minus Gt is equal to negative Vf. Now, we are going to multiply all terms by negative since Bi, Gt, and Bf are all negatives. Therefore, Bi, positive Gt, and positive Vf. Now, we are going to transfer Gt to the right side so that the initial velocity will only be left at the left side, in which it is the term that we are going to solve. Bi therefore is equal to Bf minus Gt. Okay, minus Gt. Okay. Now, in gravity, going down, G is positive. Huh? The gravity is positive, meaning positive 9.8 meter per second square. While if the object is going up, the gravity will be negative gravity. Because the object will be pulled by the force of gravity by the Earth. Therefore, having a final velocity, the object will be decreasing in speed as it goes up. While object going down, the force of gravity will be added to the velocity, therefore, as it goes down, the object will get faster and faster. Alright, the velocity going down, this is find the initial velocity of the object after 10 seconds if its final is 100 meter per second. The object is being thrown downward, Okay. Therefore, the object is being thrown downward. It falls downward. Solving the formula for initial velocity, final velocity, we have the final velocity, 100 meter per second, minus the gravity is positive 9.8 meter per second square times the given time is 10 seconds. Okay, equals the initial velocity will be 100. In order for these two terms for us to add, they should have the same unit. Positive times negative 90.8, because 10 times 9.8 is 90.8. The second here will be cancelled out. Since one is second square, the other is second, so therefore there will be 1 second left for the velocity. The unit now will be meter per second. We can now add this since these two terms are the same, having the same units. VI therefore is equal to 100 minus 90.8 is 9.2 meter per second. Okay, you can now observe that the initial velocity is very small compared with the final velocity, which is 100. Meaning, during the start of the object to fall down, it has an initial velocity of 9 meters per second. Mabagal. But as it goes downward, it gets faster and faster until it reaches 100 meter per second. Alright, another one. This one, the another example, object going upward using the same formula. Okay, I'm going to erase this one. Then I'm going to give you another example for object going upward. An object thrown upward with an initial velocity of 9 meter per second initial velocity thrown upward 100 meter per second after 10 seconds. What is the final velocity? Okay, what is being asked is the final velocity thrown upward. The object will be thrown upward at an initial velocity of 100 meter per meter, very fast. But as it goes upward, we can see by and by that the velocity will be lessened until it will reach zero, wherein after zero, the object will then return going downward again. Okay, final velocity. What will be the final velocity of the object thrown upward after 10 seconds? The formula will also be this one, final velocity. Using this one, final velocity, you will no longer transform this formula since Vf is already at the left side. Therefore, Vi plus Gt. Vf, we are going to transfer the given values of the initial velocity, which is 100 meter per second, plus this time G is negative. As I said, when an object is going upward, the gravity is negative. Therefore, negative 9.8 meter per second square times the given time, which is 10 seconds. Okay. Simplifying further, negative 9.8 times 10 is negative 90.8 meter per second only, because the second here will be cancelled out since 1 second is square while the other one is square only, then there will be second that will be left, meter per second. Okay, that will be then the initial velocity, which is meter per second. Thereby, we can now add these two because they have the same unit or they are the same terms. You can never add or subtract similar terms. You can only subtract and add terms that are similar with each other. Therefore, now we are going to multiply. Positive times negative is negative. Therefore, minus 90.8 meter per second. The same unit, meter per second. The final velocity, therefore, is 9.2 meter per second. You will observe that the initial velocity is 100, very fast. While after 10 seconds, the final velocity will now be only 9.2. It gets slower and slower at it gets upper and upper. While in the first example, as the object being thrown downward, as the object gets nearer to the ground, it gets faster and faster because of the pull of gravity. The object downward will be helped by the gravity. Therefore, the velocity will be adding. While when the object is going up, the force of the gravity will decrease the velocity of the object going upward. Okay, that will be enough for falling bodies, and we are going to discuss another topic next time. Oh yeah, tapos na. Tama lang yun, ilang minuto yun. Tapos, yung isa naman.